Hello, I'd like to show you how to calculate output probabilities for a bigram hidden Markov model. Well, we can write down the probabilities by denoting P as a probability of something, or we can write down a table. I already prepared one for you, so you won't die of eye cancer when I draw the lines by hand. So, let's start. Well, if you remember, we are in a state and you want to calculate how probable it is that from this state you have a certain output, that means a certain word. So now we have the determiner and we have the. Well, and let's see how certain it is that if you are in the state determiner that you will output the. Well, that we have here, here, here and here. So we have that 4 times. And how often do we have the when we have that? Well, we have it here. 1, 2, 3, 4. That means we have 4 over 4, and that's the same as 1. So the probability in this case, based on this data, when we are in the state that, is that we have a probability of 1 that we will get the output the. Well, let's look at students. Well, we have, I marked all cases of determiner here. And in, well, it only co-occurs with the, so we, it doesn't occur with students. So the probability for this output based on this data will be 0, because we didn't encounter a case like this in our test set. The same is with pass, test, wait, for, teachers, and also with the dot, because as you can see, the determiner only outputs the but nothing else in our dataset. Well, let's look at the nouns. So, let's mark all the nouns first. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 nouns here. Oh, sorry, 6 nouns. Let's remember that. And how often does the occur with a noun? Well, it's never. So the probability is still 0. Well, and this 4 is from the, of course. Let's look at students. I remember the 6 cases of the noun. And let's see how many of these cases we get the output students. Let's take this color and we have students. 1, 2, 3 times, so we get 3/6. And that's equal to 1/2. Yeah, let's look at pass. The noun probability is, we have still 6 nouns. Let's see how often we've got pass here. And we have 1, well, that's a verb, that doesn't matter for our noun cases, so I don't count it. And here is pass, 1 time occurring with a noun, so I write down a 1 here. And I can't simplify this any further. Let's look at test. We still encounter 6 nouns, but we want to know how many of these cases co-occurred with test. Well, and I colored pass with this one. Let's take this color for test. And we have 1, this is co-occurring with a noun. And 2, well, not 2, it's still 1 because we don't care, because this test is emitted from a verb and not from a noun. So we only have 1 case where noun emits a test. And so I write down a 1 here. Let's look at weight. I considered all. Well, we have those. I marked those cases for nouns, and we don't have any weight there, so it's. Well, it's basically. Well, it's still over 6, but it's 0 over 6, so that is the same as 0. Then we have 4, but 4 never occurs, is never emitted from a noun, so it's probability 0. Then we have teachers here. We still have noun in the denominator. And we have the teacher one time. One time it is emitted from a noun, so this is again 1 over 6. And the dot is never a noun, so the probability here is also 0. Then we want to look at the verbs. Well, we have here 1, 2, 3 verbs, so anything will be over 3. Well, let's look at the. The never co-occurs with the verb, so that is 0 over 3, and this is 0. And we have students. Students is never a verb, so the probability is 0. Then we have pass, and pass occurs is one time emitted from a verb, so we have 1 over 3. Then we have test. Test is also one time emitted from a verb. And for test, I use this color. Then we have weight. And weight is here, and it was once emitted by a verb, so it's 1 over 3. 4 is never emitted by a verb, so the probability is 0. Teachers is also never a verb, and the dot is also never a verb. Well, what's left? We have 4, which is a P. I don't remember at the moment what it was, but we only have 4 ones, and P is only once, and they co-occur together, so this is 1 over 1, so it is 1, and every other cases will be 0 because P never emits anything else than those 4. And last but not least, we have the dot 3 times, and we have punkt 3 times, so this is, well, that's a little bit ugly. We have 3 over 3, which is the same as probability 1, and the other cases are just 0. And that's how we get the output probabilities.